What's up, y'all, man? Welcome back to a new episode of Behind the Beats. Today, I'll be breaking down G Herbo, Mama. I'm sorry, man.
Left back. First off, I'm still sorry for the stuff that I did. All the lying and back talking shit I did as a kid. I was banging when you told me not. Hustling when you told me stop. And all the stupid shit I did. The love you gave me never stopped.
I don't know if I was in a session with her. I don't know if I submitted the tracks or whatnot. But at least on my end, I could remember that, you know, I'm a soulful guy. I'm the type of dude that like to sample a lot. So sometimes I don't even make beats. I just like chill and just like listen to a lot of music. And I came across this, I think I want to say progressive rock sample. But this one specifically is called Evangelist. It's like a ballad. It's like an 8 minute, 9 minute track. And I'm like, you know, I want to incorporate certain pieces that are super dope and kind of like, I want to say how, you know, hip hop, you could sample just about anything. So I felt like it was a perfect little mix. Cause like, dang, it's kind of like unfamiliar. It's an unfamiliar sound. And I wanted to blend that with, you know, my track. So typically what I do is like, I pick the parts that really touches me. And then I just like, you know, add my little sauce to it. So I just pulled a sample online, man, on YouTube. Once again, it's by Evangelist Ballad. Evangelist, the name of the song is Ballad. And I was skipping through the sample. It's a whole different vibe, you feel me? So let me go through it right now. Sometimes this is what you gotta do as a producer, man. You just gotta take your time. Like, can't rush things, it's art. You gotta be really patient. Towards the end. One thing about progressive rock or whatever, they be having so many different parts of the song where you could just, it's a whole different vibe every time. You get like breakdowns, climax, from the intro, mid, outro. There you go, right here. Once I got my chops, you know, I just started creating a vibe for myself. So I always start with my, you know, selecting my claps and my hi-hats. So my clap, got my hi-hat, and at the time I did layer it with the snare. So together it was this. Signature sound. I use that in the like Val Venus for King Louis. I used my hit, so I added this. And then lastly, I got this, you know, nice little 808. And that's pretty much my go-to 808, you know, early, what was this, 2012? I don't know, 2013? Using the slide, I rarely use, you know, a little slide glide effect, and I did it one time for this beat just to see, and it sounded pretty dope, so I was just like, you know what, but I was not with the whole glide stuff at the time. And did I add anything else? I added this cheesy piano, I guess, to make the sample stand out or hit. So I don't know why I added this. I guess to make it hit, and then I got this transition sprinkles. And what else did I do? Oh, in the beginning, I did add like. He's saying, y'all want to hear this, but I just chopped it up like. So the live drums is doing this. It adds more movement to the beat for the second half of the, like, I guess the first A bar. So half of that, I wanted to make it more I just wanted to feel it more, and then when the next panel comes, I could just remove it. So I wanted to create like a hook. So I just used the beginning of the intro. And I just came up with like a little vibe with the vocal sample. Kind of gave me like an old school vibe too, you know what I mean? But it was just really for texture and just add some type of like feeling to the beat, so it won't sound too repetitive. And I did want to add some, you know, something unique. So I'm like, man, why not? You know what I mean? Herb could either like come up with a hook, or he could just, you know, say a couple things like he did on the song, and then right back to like going crazy. So that was my whole approach, that was pretty much it, man. You know, like I said before, like once you got the samples and you already know what you want to chop up and what you want to use, like the vibe, the emotion, it's all there. So it's about like, you know, doing your part as far as the bounce, you know, and making things coexist together and, you know, make it sound like how it's supposed to. So, as far as mixing, I didn't add anything, I don't think so. Besides maybe like a delay or reverb on the vocal sample. And then if I do anything, I did use the stereo enhancer for the sample for whatever reason. I'm much to use a compressor for no reason either. Maybe to brighten up. I was using the multi-compressor maybe to make certain sounds brighter that I, you know, that I was hearing in the sample. And that was pretty much it, man. Thanks you guys for watching again. Like, comment, subscribe, do what you need to do. Share, you know what I'm saying? Let people know what's going on. I'm just sharing my production and the things I've been doing for years. Yeah, just preparing for the new C-Sick, man. I got a lot of stuff in store, so right now it's just about like sharing my old work. You know, just for me, it's like going back like 10 years back, and it's like, damn, I see the growth. I really see it. So, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed it, man. Peace out.
My mom's side.
We don't get your word.
My mom's side.
By the time I ain't ready to tell you, I'm sorry for a lot of stuff.